one of the presenters here. What's your view on sanctions on Zimbabwe?
Like I said in my presentation, sanctions are a very blunt instrument, and it's very difficult for them to be precise in terms of what we're trying to get. What I think is wrong is this idea that Zimbabwe would not be engaged at all until certain, you know, one, two, three things are done. What I would suggest is sort of a plan that outlines what the requirements of the Zimbabwean governments will be and what will be the response from the international community, and that can be monitored. And if Zimbabwe doesn't follow up on those, then we can be able to see action. But the idea that somehow Zimbabwe will remain at arm's length until those conditions, it means that for the average Zimbabwean, 10 years from now, we're going to still be having this conversation and their lives will not be improved in any way. So I think this should be coming not just from me as an African here living in Washington working at a think tank, but also from African governments in terms of supporting Zimbabwe. But I should also add that a lot of this rests on how serious the Zimbabwean government is going to be about reform.
And you talked about SADC and African Union, their role in trying to make sure that, you know, Zimbabwe is at least, you know, something is done about Zimbabwe.
Absolutely.
What were you saying?
So basically what I was saying was in terms of the limited capacity and the way the AU and SADC go about doing it, they're very strong relationships. But I believe those relationships can also be used to move Zimbabwe in that direction. Mm-hmm. And how that happens, well, you know, I'm not at the AU, so hopefully the people at the AU can be able to address that. But, you know, everybody thinks about Zimbabwe and hopes that, you know, the country gets better, especially for the ordinary people in Zimbabwe.
Thank you so much.